It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1617, recorded Tuesday, April 4th, 2017. 100 Dunb Episodes! On this episode of the Giz Wiz, you wouldn't believe it, but we have not an LED bulb. What? We're all about those LEDs. Some laser bond and the start of my new theme for the crappy corner. All next on the Giz Wiz!
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology.
Rows and rows of USBs, growing, glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the maestro of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing good, sir. And you?
I am doing good myself. It's been a fine week, and of course we're recording this early, so we are both going to do crazy stuff this next week.
I'm going to Pepcom on Thursday, and you're doing something tomorrow?
And is that Pepcom in Vegas?
No, Pepcom in New York, fortunately. Ooh. Yeah, I'm so tired of going to Vegas. Yeah.
Nobody needs to go to Vegas. Yeah,
Pepcom in New York. They have a spring event, so I'm looking forward to that.
Perfect.
And you, what are you doing?
I am going first to San Francisco, and there is a private meeting about people who do Minecraft stuff, and we're going to have a dinner with the Mojang people who make the game, and that's happening in San Francisco. And then I'm immediately flying to Washington, D.C., and having a mini vacation with a friend for their birthday, so it'll be fun. It's some work, but also some play. So having a good
and a lot trip. Of flying.
A lot of flying. A lot of flying. Yeah.
Do you enjoy flying?
I do. I do.
Oh,
I
like okay. Flying. Good. Good. Okay.
Yeah. I'd rather fly than I think any other form of transportation. Yeah.
All right. Okay.
Other than you know what? Okay. Wait. I'd take that back. Rocket ships. I would rather fly in a rocket ship than fly in an airplane. But since that's not really available, I'll settle for the plane. What about you, though?
Do I like flying?
No, yeah.
I am so tired of flying. You know, I have 600,000 miles with United. Fortunately, it's enough miles that now everywhere I go, I just go first class. Of course, you can do it for miles. You know, when I went to CES, it was 100,000 miles and $5.
Yeah, exactly.
that is so funny. This one monitor was offline the whole time, trying to get it to come on, couldn't get it to come on, and it decided now to come
finally.
On.
Finally. Yeah, finally. Oh, I'm alive. Here, you can hear
during
me.
During the show. Yeah. and so I'm spoiled.
Yeah, that's pretty nice. Once you choose, if you're someone like us that chooses a flight, club, and then actually flies a lot, and if those points don't expire, you have, every once in a while, there'll just be a month where it's just like, points.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. They do make you a loyalty person because of that.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. Especially if like Microsoft is paying for the flight. I'm like, can we please book with so-and-so airline just because?
Yes, you know, no, I've, yes, the same with me. With something. Can you come out and be a guest on so-and-so? We'll buy a ticket. I said, will you buy a ticket on United?
Exactly. Exactly.
And the other good thing is I have a United. United is affiliated with Chase.
Right.
So if you have a Chase United credit card, you don't have to worry. Miles never expire, even if you never fly.
Right.
It's just that you keep the credit card keeps the miles alive. So that's a good perk.
Right. Exactly. Man, we have a jam-packed episode of the Giz Wiz.
Okay.
Today.
Yes.
We really do. We have Dick has three gadgets. Dick goes back to the warehouse. in the start of my crappy corner. So let's jump into it.
Yeah, which I don't even know what the theme is yet, but I'll learn. Okay, so we're going to look at a kind of unique bulb that's not LED.
Not LED? What is wrong with us?
Oh, my God.
Dick DeBartolo, man's maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv. You know, LED bulbs, we love them. We talk about them all the time. But there are times where incandescent bulbs are softer and more fun. How can a bulb be fun? I'll show you. Okay, we're going to go into the bathroom. And let me just... That's how is that
good
for brightness?
Good.
Okay.
Very nice.
These are Rolet vintage bulbs, antique Edison style bulbs.
There'll be a better shot that in a minute.
And I love the fact that you can see the filament. Now the thing is, we have a Galaxy S6, which is very great in the dark. So if you brighten them just a little too much, they'll just look like ordinary bulbs. Are they too bright already?
Mm-hmm.
They are. Okay. So, turn them on down. I love the look here. I actually bought them for my bathroom. I'll turn them up again. And when Dennis saw them, he said, I have to get them for my bathroom upstairs. And they're relatively inexpensive. Four of them are $17. And six of them, I think, are about $22. They're 370 lumens, totally dimmable because they're incandescent. But the burn life is about 3,000 hours. Again, you're probably going to use them like in a bathroom or in a lamp. And you're not going to read by it. I think you're just going to have it as sort of a showpiece. So you're not going to use them that much. But they are Rolet vintage bulbs, antique Edison bulbs, and they're a regular 120 volts and a regular light bulb socket. Now,
nice.
I'm going to show you a way to sort of achieve this effect using an LED bulb, and that'll come after the fade.
Okay, so this is sort of the LED version of the old-fashioned Edison bulb. So when you actually see it here in the bulb, it does look kind of like the bulbs we saw earlier. But this being an LED, and when I bought it, I didn't realize it was non-dimmable. I'm going to turn it on, and it kind of looks more like a light bulb. It gives off, I'll just show you. Okay,
ooh.
So you can see, that's probably just making the camera crazy. You can see, ta-da!
Okay.
You can see the elements.
Actually, you can see the elements in the reflection.
A nice glow. Unlike, you know,
right, that little
LED
thing that's floating around looks like,
yes,
and it is. I'm blinded by the light. It was $12, and this I think is 30,000 hours. It's so funny, it was so bright that my eyes can't adjust.
You remember correct, his eyesight might be going, but his memory isn't.
The Edison look in an LED bulb that'll last. The other one is 3,000 to 30,000. What is that, 100 times? Something like that. LED Edison bulb. Ta-da! Avert your eyes.
What a bright idea.
Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and a Thomas Edison in his own way, and Mads Maddest Writer. One take theater here at gizwiz.tv. Bye.
It's funny. Old has become new again. Look
yes.
at the old-fashioned bulb. Look how great this is.
Yes.
But yeah, absolutely. There's a lot of scenarios where the bulb is such a visual aspect of whatever the light fixture is that having an old-fashioned bulb makes a lot of sense. I have them same sort of situation in the bathroom above the mirror. There's vanity bulb, you know, sort of situations. This is great. Not expensive, dimmable, kind of going back to the old-fashioned stuff. It does make a lot of sense.
Oh yes, you have the LED version, not that.
No,
version.
In my house they came with incandescent. No.
Oh, and they were dimmable.
Well, I guess I don't have.
Oh,
a
Oh, that's
dimmable
right. They are
thing.
Dimmable.
They are
because they're incandescent. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't have a dimmable slider on that right. in the bathroom, but yeah. Now, and the ones that are in there are the like the globe style, so that it's like almost a perfect sphere instead of, you know, I don't know what you would call this, a teardrop style that kind of
I'm getting depressing news from the chat room.
Uh-oh.
On sale at Newegg.
What?
Dimmable Edison bulbs, $10 for six.
Oh, my gosh.
Our chat room.
They are the deal finders. We just need a podcast where we call out gadgets that we want to buy, and they find the best price. And
there we go.
That's the whole thing. Let me find it. Here we are. 60-watt dimmable Edison bulbs, six-pack. I didn't find it correctly. I found this one is $19.99.
It says GMY Lighting.
I don't know if they found this correctly, because this is what I see. Maybe someone forgot to copy the one.
That could be.
We need a link.
They're pretty close, and actually they're a little cheaper than Amazon. About $3. $3.
Yeah.
Oh, it's 2,500 lifetime hours, not 3,000. Warm white, dimmable, and good looking, and very breakable.
Did you break one already?
We broke the LED version, which was, I believe, glass. Most LEDs are plastic, but these guys are glass. And Dennis was screwing it in, and it didn't catch, and he thought it had caught onto the... onto the socket, and it suddenly let go and hit the sink.
I'd assume it's not great, because you could, touch it or something. But, incandescent, globe is filled with a gas that will cause the element not to burn out.
I screwed it back in.
Okay, we think alike.
It lights.
Yeah.
It lights.
You don't want to touch it. I mean, there's probably, the circuitry is just floating there. So you could easily. Yes.
No, but I just wanted to see. I said, none of the elements separated. It just doesn't have a protective case.
Yeah. Interesting. Very cool. I mean,
it does light.
Very dangerous.
It's very
dangerous. Don't try
this
at home. Professional Giz Wiz.
This is the second time it happened because I have LEDs and we have this little fake greenhouse in the bed. Not a fake greenhouse. It's just tiny, a 4x6 foot greenhouse that we can use in cold weather. And one day I was looking out and I was going, what is that weird light in the greenhouse? And I went out and when no one was there, the globe had fallen off the LED light, but the light stayed lit. So evidently the globes around LEDs are just put there for your protection.
Wow.
The lights keep on going.
So it's Ochre 86 sent over the link, and I didn't know this, but apparently there is a website called Newegg Flash. And Newegg Flash has the exact same thing for $10. This is why the chat room finds the best deals.
Oh, my gosh. That's great.
Is this not incredible? They are selling the same thing on normal Newegg for $10 more. And then you just go over to Newegg Flash, get $10 off right there. It's the same product.
So, it's probably just for today then, right?
I guess. It doesn't... I'm sure... Flash...
And it's...
would assume that there's a flash deal.
Yeah, flash is usually, 24 hours or... Amazing. Amazing.
Yeah. Oh, wow, the front of the thing is all light bulbs, unless if I've been bubbled, but wow.
Holy cow.
That's incredible. Yeah, this is great. Edison vintage style. Here's a different one, more of a globe.
This is very similar to the one I have, although it's almost the same price as on Amazon. That is almost... exactly this bulb.
Yeah, that's incredible.
Isn't it?
Okay, good. Thank you so much, Ochre. If you happen to be watching this...
Our chat room is super.
Ah, man, super. They're great. Okay, so Edison-style bulbs in LED versions and incandescent versions available on Amazon, Newegg,
exactly.
Newegg Flash.
Exactly. And the LED version says not dimmable, just so you know.
Right.
Chad, we're going to show a little bit of a commercial. It's not a sponsor. We're just showing a commercial so you can get an idea of how miraculous this product is.
Okay, okay. So here's here it is on YouTube. Yep. Let's make sure we can listen to
things
it.
Things break all the time. So you try messy glue, but now you're stuck holding pieces together. Fingers stick and glue never works. What you need is Laser Bond, the amazing liquid plastic that fixes, fills, fastens, and seals virtually anything in as little as 3 seconds. Laser Bond is not a glue or epoxy, but a unique liquid plastic that only hardens with the UV light.
I hope it
Watch
makes that
in real
sound.
Time. Simply apply, peel the UV light, and in just 3 seconds, you have a permanent repair that lasts. Plastic, metal, glass, or wood, repairs are fixed right with a UV light. The magic? A powerful liquid plastic compound that hardens strong as a rock under ultraviolet light. Now fill in plumbing leaks in 3 seconds or less.
Can you, I can,
repair
cannot
kids'
believe
toys
it.
And keep playtime flying. The best part? The adhesive is made in the USA, so it's guaranteed to hold tight or your money back.
Wow, that is fast.
It bends, it's flexible.
I just want to get where they saw a boat in half.
Oh my God, they saw a boat in half.
Laser Bond connect both ends? Wow, the boat floats with no danger to the passenger. Amazing. Laser Bond can be sanded and painted.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, we can go out.
Yeah, there we go. Anything that uses that break sound effect, like just let's just listen to that again. It's like, oh, I broke my arm.
Things break.
It's like, it looks like she broke her foot, I swear. Things. It's first up, oh, snap. Oh, my ankle. Ah, bring the Laser Bond. My foot.
Oh, there you go. Forget having a medical insurance. All
exactly.
You need is a tube of Laser Bond.
Do you break your arm? Laser Bond.
Oh, there you go. Perfect. And I'm suddenly realizing, oh, okay. So I bought Laser Bond. I had it sitting around, and I finally broke a pair of glasses the other day, and I thought, Laser Bond. I don't have the sound effects, but let's see how we fared with Laser Bond.
DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Have you heard about Laser Bond? Laser Bond that will repair in 3 seconds. Okay. And I love on Amazon that they actually couldn't even get the package to stand straight up. It's liquid resin that seals in just 3 seconds. I think Boeing uses it to attach wings to airplanes, but they have a big tube for that. Okay, so this is Laser Bond right here, okay? And it seals with UV light. There's a little Try Me button. And, oh, it does work. Oh,
Oh, it's attached to your finger.
To the package. It's amazing. Okay, so
we
I'm
can
not,
break that off.
Okay, so what we're gonna do is I finally found a use for it. Oh, the wrong ones. Okay, so these are just magnifiers because I have an idea that we're gonna ruin them. The lens fell out because the frame cracked. Okay. Now I have zero
crack sound effect
for this kind of thing. So in a second, I'm going to take the camera, and Dennis, who's an artist and works in many mediums, some of them rare, he's going to fix my glasses in 3 seconds. Okay. Be right back.
Okay, so the Giz Wiz is holding the camera now, and it's kind of neat that on the Laser Bond package, they used it to fix glasses. So the frame is broken. Dennis, we have the Laser Bond out. You open the end of the Laser Bond opposite the light, and that reveals the little... Ta-da. So I'm not as good at the camera as Dennis is. He's putting that
I like
on.
The sound.
He's pushing it together.
The okay. lens is falling out.
He's breaking it again.
And,
we got to play the sound effect every time it breaks.
Look at the instructions. It says, you can keep repeating steps 2 and 3, which is the putting the Laser Bond on and the curing as many times as possible till you get the desired result, which I guess means do it as many times as possible until something sticks. All right. He's applied the laser. And now 1/1000, 2/1000, 3-1000. You know, we're going to go a little longer because it says 3 to 8 seconds. Oh, did the light go out? Oh, I think the light goes out automatically. Okay.
Hopefully it's dry. If it's not, it's way longer than 3 seconds.
Right, do you think? Does it look like it's together? It might be hot, it says.
It's hard.
I don't know how it could be hot, but...
It is.
Yeah.
All right. Here, this is going to be pretty amazing. Let me give you that.
Watch out, Dennis! Oh, gosh, he broke it.
And see... Well, maybe they worked. The lens is a little foggy at the bottom, but that's probably from your fingertips. Hang on.
It's breaking in different places.
It's breaking his nose. Oh, no. Use a laser wand.
Blue everywhere. Okay. I'm just going to clean this up a little.
Oh, you broke your glasses again.
You know what? I think we got glue on the glasses. But that's okay. Because, in effect, it did work. I think the glasses are a little cloudy because we probably got some glue on them. But that's it. So, for us, it did work. Laser bond, 3-second bonding agent. I'm looking on Amazon here. 242 consumer. Go over here, Dennis, for a second. 28% liked it. 43% hated it. Okay, so it got 2.6 stars out of 5. So roughly 50% of the people liked it. That was stuck to his arm. Your results may vary. Dick DeBartolo, Man's Madness Writer in the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. It's holding my mustache on. Bye.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, my mustache broke, too.
That is, work.
It kind of did work. I mean, it's kind of, you know, you can tell right here that it's put together. But like in Vegas at CES, for some reason, one of the this earpiece thing broke off the glasses. That probably would have held it on at least for the rest of the show. Right. I ended up doing a crappy tape job. So, but a lot of people thought it just didn't work at all. The other thing, I have no idea what the shelf life is because now you have that stuff in the tube. It says wipe the end of the tube off before you put it away. We did that. And a lot of people online are saying that you don't need the light.
Oh.
But... I don't know. Let's put it this way. It's better than I thought it would be. It's anywhere from, if you can go back to that Amazon thing, I think that was the cheapest I saw it. I think it's $8.99.
Yeah, $8.99 with free shipping.
$8.99 and free shipping. And it's sold under a lot of different names. Like this is Laser Bond, and then there's Laser Repair, and then there's Laser something. But they're all pretty much that same pen.
Like Rapid Fix.
Rapid Fix.
This thing, 5-second liquid plastic work welding kit. Okay. Look, there's your glasses they're using.
Yes. I guess the... so it's a little messy. I do think we got some glue on the glass. But, here's another company.
Yeah.
Isn't that funny?
Must
have got it from the same company, but the company made it in a different color for them.
Right, exactly.
Because it looks exactly the same.
Interesting.
So it's not a disaster, but I would not, if my boat ever has an accident, I'm not going to repair it with laser
bond. Can you imagine the poor individual? Okay, guys, here's the pitch. We're going to saw this boat in half. And then put it together with Liquid Fix. Great. Do you have a gallon of this stuff? We got these pins. Each pin covers about a 3-inch area.
Yes, exactly.
Please use 35 pins for that foot area. Oh my gosh, poor guy.
I know. anyway, so that is Laser Bond. And disappointingly, it worked.
Yeah.
It would have been funny if it just fell apart. But we don't hide stuff here. One take theater.
It worked.
It worked for us, so we're happy about it.
Possibly the sun will be your UV light. That's the only thing you need.
That could be. Okay, my final gadget is two gadgets, and they're just two cheap little gadgets you may not know about. And here they are.
Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz. One take theater here at gizwiz.tv. A couple of little gadgets that you may not know about. We could do what the heck is it with this first one. What is that?
Do you know right off the bat, Chad?
Well, this will
I bought
sort
one,
of
so
give
yeah.
you a much okay. better hint. Belkin. And this should be a dead giveaway. Okay. So it is the Belkin headphone splitter. And what's neat about this is if you have a group of people like kids in a car and everybody wants to listen to the same music, this goes into the headphone jack. Five people can listen to that audio source. And why it's great here at Disneyland is when I record the show, sometimes guests come by. Either when I'm doing Twit with Leo or this with Chad, everybody has to be on headsets when we're recording, so there's no feedback. So I used to have wires running everywhere. This now is an easy way for four other people to plug in. And that's over on Amazon. That's where I bought it. It's called the Belkin Rockstar Multi-Headphone Splitter. And it comes in many colors, and it's under $15. So I like that.
This would make you a popular
guy
in high
school. So that was gadget number one from Belkin. And I have a new phone. This is the LG G6. All right, it's a beautiful phone. A great screen, 2-to-1 ratio. So if you're watching widescreen movies, it looks great on this. I'm going to do a full video on that. But the reason that I found the next little gadget was because of the phone. This new LG phone charges with USB-C, okay? So USB-C, actually a lot of phones are coming out with that. USB-C is great because you can plug it in either side and you don't have to worry about flipping it over. Although, a few months ago we did these cables, micro USB, again, either side, you can't plug them in wrong. You can find that at gizwiz.biz. The thing is, of course, the LG comes with one data charging cable with USB-C. And I'm thinking, oh, you know, I have so many devices that use micro USB. Now when I travel, I have to have a bunch of cables. Does anybody make a little converter so that I could use micro USB on a USB-C device? Ta-da! Anchor! We've talked about Anker on the show a lot. I bought a lot of stuff from them. So Anker has these little USB-C to micro USB adapters. So all you do is you take that little guy and it goes right on there. When I travel, I'll just have this to charge the LG G6 and then take this off to charge my little USB micro devices. This was on Amazon, two of them for $7, $6.99. And if you know, if you check on Amazon, they make them for, you can get micro USB to lightning connectors for an iPhone. They're like $9 or $10 because they have to be Apple certified, so that makes the price a little bit higher. I even found these. I have an old Galaxy Tab. Remember the Tab?
Oh, my gosh.
Must be like 6 or 7 years ago. And I thought, you know, I'm going to leave the Tab on the boat and use it to watch movies. I could not find the charging cable for the Tab. And then I thought, I bet you someone makes an adapter. And sure enough, this is USB micro to that old wonky...
the Tab.
Ta-dan, connector.
It looks just like the Apple
Galaxy. Okay.
It does. It's, I think, a 30-pin.
30-pin guy. and they were also very cheap. So there are a couple of gadgets you may not know about, very handy, relatively inexpensive. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Medis writer, and the Giz Wiz, your adaptable host here at gizwiz.tv. Bye!
Interesting. So now you know if you needed a some type of cable adapter or that headphone splitter. I don't think that design has changed in 10 years because I think I bought a lime green and white version of that.
Oh, that's so funny.
A long, long time ago. And they work great because there's plenty of times when other people want to share something that only has a single headphone port. I wonder if this is going to be a device of the past with Bluetooth. Is it easy to share a Bluetooth connection so other people can listen in if they have their own Bluetooth headphones? That'd be interesting. I'm not sure.
This is more secure without someone saying, "Well, Ma, I can't hear you with my."
Exactly. You know? Well, yeah, exactly.
Sometimes things that plug in are just easier.
Way easier. In fact, whenever I do a shoot, you know, I have wireless microphone adapters and things like that. No, give me an XLR cable any day. Plug that XLR cable directly into the camera. I don't want to deal with wireless in a
especially at a show
situation.
Where 90 million people are using Bluetooth and
exactly. Yeah, I would much rather use a cable. So yeah, I can agree with that. So $15 for the Belkin Rockstar multi-headphone splitter in black, or you can get some Anker products. Anker's one of those companies that, God, it just feels like they haven't done anything wrong. And
no, you're right. They're, you know, they're great.
Their products
and
just
very
work.
Reasonable.
Very reasonable price. Designed, you know, pretty minimalistic. You know, I've never been upset with their design. And they just kind of do a good job. They're just kind of there, you know. I don't know any Anker representative or any Anker, like, I don't know. It seems like they almost don't talk to the press at all, but then they're just there, and they're really making good products all the time.
And the other thing is, let me just turn around and see if I have that blister pack. I don't know where it was, but oh, yeah, just show that thing on Amazon. So the two of them are in this blister about actually... there's a packaging not there. Sure. The two of them are in a blister pack, and I go, oh, gosh, let me see if I can cut one out, and then I'll leave the other one in because I want to show it in the video. And then I see a little tab at the top. The blister pack just pops open, so you don't have to cut anything. And I'm thinking,
oh, there it is. Boop.
There you go. There you go. Yeah,
oh, yeah, there's a little arrow right there. I see.
Yes.
Oh.
To pop it open. And the two little tabs are in there in their own little pockets. I'm thinking that's a little extra something that someone really thought about, that when you get it and you're traveling, the worst is when you're traveling, you need something that's blister packed.
Yeah, exactly.
And, you know, you can't even use a regular knife on it. You have to have something substantial. There.
Pops right open.
Yeah. Yeah, so Anker, thank you for being
thoughtful. Amazon reviews also just say it all. I mean...
Yeah. Oh, look at 82%. Whoa.
What, 2% one star. I mean, there's only... there's not a lot you can do in this world. We're only 2% of the people will be mad at you. So, yeah, good job on them. Okay, cool. With that...
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for us all, including me, to learn about the theme for Chad's crappy April Corner.
Get it.
Okay, so we asked the patrons.
Show us the box, and then we'll guess the theme.
Oh, I think you'll be, okay, here we go. This is the box. We, of course, asked the patrons what we should... be doing this month. See it?
Is it art projects?
There we go. We got a little animal set, 14 pieces.
Oh, it's cute. Is it?
Okay. It makes build anything you can imagine.
Is it mini kits as the theme?
Ooh, no, close. That'd be a good theme. A kit theme. We need to have
a kit theme.
A brainstorm. The options were between, let me pull this up. You're going to get it once I say it. Camping gadgets, party gadgets, and finally, magnetic gadgets. Magnets are this month's theme. So any gadget with some magnets in it. So this is Magna Flex, and this is a toy. In fact, I bought this one because of the short time in between the two episodes. I didn't get the questionnaire up until 5 a.m. this morning, so I didn't have any time to buy it off of Amazon. I forgot it. Slipped my mind. So ran to Toys R Us. I thought toys are always a fun gadget to show off. I always had a lot of fun showing off toys. So Magnaflex is the toy that I found. And it's pretty simple in design. And what comes inside the packaging are a few magnetic sort of bendable things. And this is the inside of the package. I've already opened this up. There's a lot of bags. Each one of these was in a bag. So you get these magnets, and there's three magnets per thing. You have one on the end, and the one on the other end, and one in the middle. And so they give you instructions to kind of make origami shapes to build for yourself. So you get eight of these various strips, and then you get a few, I think it's six total. You get two black metal things. These are not magnetic, but of course, I mean, they are magnetic, but they don't have a charge on them.
Oh, okay,
The magnet will attach. And then four of these white sort of eye things, but on the other side, the white sort of makes a border, so they could be eyeballs. On this side, the black makes a border so that you have white on the inside. So you could use this, of course, to make your own creation. Let's go ahead and make one. It comes with a whole bunch of different options. Fish, owl, a fox, a cat. On the other side, we have a turtle, and we also have a dog. Let's go ahead and make, what should we make?
Make a dog and see if Charlie likes
dog.
It.
Okay, here we go. So the dog, the first step is to find two of these guys. Now, in making, I already played a little bit with them. Obviously, magnets are magnets. So sometimes they're going to repel and sometimes they're going to attract. Yes. So we got this that attracts right here. We actually need to start with two blacks that attract and then a one on top. So we flip it around like that. Then inside, these are toothed just a little bit. So you can take one and slide it into the other like this, so you can kind of force a 90 degree angle into them. So if they're,
and that has nothing to do with the magnet.
That's
being just bound in there.
Yeah, okay. Exactly. So now we can kind of make it connect, and now we sort of have a dog's face, just like that. So now the next step is to take these guys. Let's snap one, two, and flip that over. There we go. And then do the same thing on the other side. So let's grab that and that and that. And now we have sort of a body of a dog. And that was step two. And it says step three is to take these guys, kind of split them apart, and then fold them back on each other. And those are sort of like arms. Put that right there. Whoa. And sometimes these aren't very movable once you kind of get it fixed. And then you take this and attach it right there, and then move this forward. And we kind of have a dog.
Lying down dog, right?
Lying down dog. And then here, I'm going to detach it so you can kind of see what I'm going to do here with the face. Is we're going to take one of these and snap it to the magnet in the middle, and one on the other side, snap it to the magnet in the middle. And I have a kind of a better face. And let's put this guy into my hand
it's very cute.
See it a little bit better. Attach that back there. And there we go. We sort of have a little dog.
Oh, that's very cute.
His arms don't want to cooperate on my hand on the table. It's a little bit better.
People in the chat room are saying, do they have an age group recommendation?
Yeah, there is three and up. Three and up is
three and up. Okay.
Age group recommendation.
Fortunately, anyway, that covers everybody in the chat room.
Exactly. Anyone in the chat, as long as you can remember things, at age three, they say your memories start working. There you go. You got it. So I don't know. I think it, now the one thing is I don't know how creative you can be outside of these instructions. So obviously, creativity is the limit with a toy like this. This was, I'm going to go ahead and just kind of throw together a turtle as I'm talking. I don't know. It does seem a little limited, I would say, just because what, you know, I don't know. They're just these sort of, I don't know. There's not, it doesn't, you know, where is your imagination going to go? It almost feels like.
Right.
But. I mean, that being said, it's just like, you know, you're going to have as much fun as you want to have.
Yeah.
With something like this.
Well, so. I think a lot will depend on what it cost.
Yes. Yeah. So this little set that I bought was not on sale. So kind of keep that in mind because I'm sure that it could be on sale. This was $20.
$20. Oh, okay. That was my top guess, is that no more than $20.
Yeah, exactly. $20. So this is supposed to be a turtle. Turtle with little feet, little face. I don't know.
Well, it certainly spurs the imagination.
Exactly.
Yeah,
and it forces you to use your imagination just a little bit. and one thing that I would say is a downside is they're not very, you kind of set them on the, it's almost like this would be a perfect desk toy for adults because you can't really play with this. I couldn't really much with it. It's a turtle. It sits there. But the moment that you want to move it around, it kind of starts to fall apart unless if you're really holding it delicately like I am right now. So, that is the Magniflex.
$20.
I found it on at Toys R Us, but you can find it. I couldn't find this on Amazon, but I would put that to the chat room because they find it.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm waiting for the chat room to say, Chad, it's $1 at $5 below.
Exactly. It's made by Wowee. Wowee is a brand that...
oh, my gosh.
Yeah, we've covered a few times on the Giz.
Oh, yeah.
But there you go. So you can see these creations if you get much, much more than we have. But once again, these are so delicate. You can see that they're just kind of sitting on the desk.
Yes.
There.
Kids are touching each other instead of the toy.
Right, exactly. Oh, this is a kind of a cool idea because they're magnets. Of course, you can throw them at something magnetic. Unfortunately, their website's not working for me. But,
right.
But yeah, you could throw it on something magnetic.
You know that crown on that girl... I think they used a laser bond to hold that.
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah. It's a statue contest. Oh, this is kind of cute. A little bug. Wow, their website not working. But, it does say Amazon. Okay, well, apparently I did not do... Wow, what is it saying? You are leaving Wowee. Are you sure? Okay, there we go. We found it on Amazon.
Oh, there, it's the same price, $20.
Magnum.
And what's below that? Is there, like, giant sets?
I bet so. I bet that you could buy a humongous set. Yeah, this is $50.
What?
For the, it doesn't say how many pieces are in this. I'm not sure. I can't see right off the bat how many pieces are in this. But yeah, mine was a 14-piece set. But remember that the six little, whatever these things are called, discs. Those are pieces as well.
Magnetic discs.
Yeah. So you only got 8 of the actual strips, magnetic strips. And then you got 6 of the magnetic discs. So I don't know.
I think a kid would have fun for a while.
I think so too. I mean, and also, you know, you always kind of need maybe a monster. And, you know, if you have a Lego set, you know, add a monster.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Something
yeah.
like that. I don't know. It also does travel very well. I mean, all together, you know, this is basically the entire set, except minus the discs. So if you wanted to take this and travel with it, you okay, make something now, go. It does feel a little bit like origami sometimes, though. So that is the Magniflex from Wowee, $20 for a 14-piece set. You can find it on Amazon, Toys R Us. And a few more, wowee.com. And that about wraps up for this. We'll have some more magnet gadgets in the future. With that, let's jump into Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn! And Dick's Gadget Warehouse. We didn't have a video this week from anybody new, so we need videos for next week. We'll start doing video repeats from people who have sent in videos before. So this week I went to the warehouse, found an old gadget, and here it is.
Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Back to Dick's Gadget Warehouse for a gadget. We're taping this in April 2017, so this gadget is celebrating its 13th birthday, although it died a long time ago. Okay, it is from iOmega, the Floppy Plus. And what was the plus? The plus was a 7-in-1 card reader. So this was back when floppy disks were on their way out. But people might have had floppy disks that they wanted to copy stuff from. So this is actually a very good idea. So the Floppy Plus was USB powered. And you could put in floppy. You know, if you don't remember floppy disks, this is what they looked like, okay?
And it's the save icon made real.
Into your computer. If you had old floppy disks, you could then read it. Your computer would recognize this as a drive. But wait, there's more. Look at all these slots up here. This could read compact flash, smart media. I don't even remember what smart media was. Micro drives. I think those were from IBM. Multimedia cards. I believe they're dead. Secure digital. They're still around. SD cards. Sony's memory stick, which is just a memory. And memory stick pro. And floppy disks. It sold for $60. Let me see, anything else about it? Oh, the data transfer rate was 12 megabits a second. That's kind of slow. As a matter of fact, this disk is a movie that I was copying, and it just finished. So it just took 13 years, but it was a long movie. That's it. No longer around. It could you could use it with Windows 98. And the very popular Windows ME and even XP. So that's it. The iOmega Floppy Plus. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Bye.
The Microsoft ME, my family actually had that.
Oh, did they?
We used ME for a little while. It was.
Oh my God! Millennium edition, right?
Yes.
Oh God! Yes. You know, I'm looking at the box, Chad. So compact flash, not around anymore, right?
I don't think so. That name doesn't ring a bell.
Smart media. I don't even. Do you remember what smart media was?
No.
Okay. Multimedia card media. No idea what that was. Memory stick. I assume that's totally dead.
Now, unless if that's the memory, like I remember getting a memory stick in my Sony camera, that might still be around.
Yeah, maybe. It looked like a shortened piece of gum, right? Like a stick of gum.
Yeah.
Cut off.
Memory stick. Okay, let's see if.
If it's still around, and then they had something called Memory Stick Pro.
Yeah, I think this was the Memory Stick Duo. I remember these definitely. I don't know.
Oh, okay, okay.
Basically should use SD cards because they're the big one. I remember using this definitely though.
Oh, okay.
4 megabytes.
I mean,
You get a whole image on that right there.
I know. You know, it's so funny. I was looking at and I'm thinking, 4 gigabytes for $5. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Oh, well, this is good. So now we see. Memory stick.
Pro Duo apparently is in up to 2 gigabytes ish. I mean, there's an 8 gigabyte one. Memory sticks, they don't look like they went above a few megabytes. So
no.
That one probably died. That one's probably dead.
Yeah, and I think the micro drive was from IBM, and I think the micro drive was actually a little memory drive. Like I think, and I think they were like hundreds of dollars.
Wow.
I have someone somewhere around. I'll go find it and do it as a gadget warehouse. So anyway, you heard we need more videos for Dick's Gadget Warehouse. You have a little bit of time now because we're taping on a Tuesday, but we need a video for a week from Thursday. As I said, next week we may do a video from someone who's sent in videos before. But if you're a fan of the show and you haven't sent in a video yet, it is so easy. It's pretty much anything you own that is gadgety because the chat room loves anything gadgety. So just make a little video, 2 to 3 minutes, put it on YouTube. When you upload it, there's a little drop down menu. Click unlisted. That way, only people with the link will watch the video and send us that link. Send it to mail@gizwiz.tv. And if we show it on the show, and we've shown almost everything sent in, you'll get a Mad Magazine and one of those 35-year-old Alfred E. Newman pictures, which I will now send myself because my video got on this.
Good. Congratulations.
This week's show. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I always wanted to be on the Giz Wiz.
That's great. And now moving on to the letters.
And our letter is from Mike Gunn in San Francisco, who has an idea for Chad. It's actually, he's probably doing it partly as a joke, but actually this is a great idea. Hey, Chad, just a suggestion for a product to use if you ever go over to Dickie's place and you need to cover up some of the LEDs so you can get some sleep. And if you go to that link, he is suggesting black post-it notes.
What?
You know what? This is a great idea to throw like 10 of those in your suitcase at hotels.
Yeah.
Where they have thermostats or any device that lights up and drives you crazy. It is a super temporary way to block out light. You don't need to carry tape with you. Just a black post-it note over small bright lights. This is an excellent idea.
This is great. And it also is a security device. We should have covered this last month because you can put it right over a webcam and the government can't see you. It's perfect.
There you go. They go, the government says, God, those people live in total darkness.
What the heck? Gosh,
we've
darn
never
it.
Turned. We've never turned on their camera to
foiled
see
again
them
by
in
the most incredible technology of yes. Post-it note foiled.
They must
can't spy on these people.
Right. Right. You know, if 3M was smart, they would sell them to the government as military grade. Webcam covers.
Or they would say a single post-it note.
$30 a sheet.
$30 for a right. webcam reusable right.
RDIF blocking. total blackout. Yeah.
Exactly. Those look very classy.
I can't think of many other uses
for a black post-it note unless if you are constantly writing in silver pen.
Yes.
There's
actually, you know, black post-its and the silver pen, a very elegant way to sign autographs.
Yeah, definitely. Very nice.
You know?
Very nice.
And if you're looking for a way to block out LEDs on a more permanent basis, I'll just remind people about, did I send you the link to
Light dims.
Light dims. We did light dims on the show. These are very effective, relatively inexpensive. You get like 40 of them on a sheet, and you can get them to dim the light like 40% or dim the light 50%, or they make sheets called blackouts where you just stick it over the LED and it doesn't shine through at all. But they're, you know, a post-it note is great for a hotel because you just pick it off when you leave.
Right.
These actually stick onto the device and don't even look like they're there, but they do tend to. I forgot, I had an alarm clock that was just ridiculously bright, especially when I set the alarm and had this big red light that went on to tell you the alarm was set. And I just put one over that, and it was great. I could tell the alarm was on, but it was not shining into the room like an air raid.
I need to find my set because I constantly...
Oh, you have a set?
Yeah, I have a set of light dims, and I've been looking for them because I use a travel power strip. The problem is there is a blue LED. Whenever you plug it in, it's perfectly positioned to shine bright right into your eyes no matter where you place it in a hotel room, that travel power strip, it has the worst LED on top of it. I'm trying to find the brand of power strip that I actually use, but I don't see it. Yeah, I need this to permanently attach, or I might take some spray paint to it and just get rid of that LED. I don't need to see
it. Get rid of it totally. Oh,
okay. It's like, I can tell that this thing is plugged in. I don't need an LED to tell me that it's plugged in. Thank you. But yeah, definitely. This is it right here. I don't know. I forget the brand.
It's a Monster Cable, isn't it?
Is that it? Yeah, it's basically this. Whatever this is. Travel Power Strip.
From Monster.
Yeah, this is it. Let's visit the page. And it has a bright LED right there. Yeah, Monster Power. Yes. I love this thing so much. I don't travel anywhere
without it. No, I have one of them,
too.
It is, yeah.
Have you ever stayed...
And, wow, this was made a long time ago. That camera and stuff on there is pretty old.
Yes.
Yeah, there it is.
No,
I wonder
I
if
do
it'll
like
show
it,
that LED. I really want them to.
Flip that over. Oh, there we go. And the flat plug I like.
Yeah, yeah. And it plugs into itself, so it's very
for
compact.
Travel.
Yeah, this is one of my favorite gadgets.
Right. And then
there it is, the blue LED!
There it
gosh,
is.
Gosh, dang it! Oh, my gosh. Hate that thing. So, yeah, I need to to upgrade some way to turn that.
Black electrical tape will do it.
There we go. I have light dims. I think that's also been holding me back on doing anything to it because I know that I have light dims somewhere, and this it's the product I bought that is made for this, and I just feel like anything else I'm cheating myself. Thanks, Mike, for sending that over. That's a good idea. And with that, I want to give a big thank you to our patrons, Patreon.com.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, this is show 100.
Independent show number 100.
So four more shows, and Patreon members, you have kept us alive for 2 full years.
Thank you for reminding me. Yes, I meant to say that right at the beginning. 100 independent shows. That is just such an accomplishment, and it really makes me proud that our audience is an audience that can support us. And our main support is through Patreon. We do know that there's been some fantastic people who have donated through PayPal as well, so don't feel like we're forgetting you, PayPal donators. But big, big, big thank you. It's just really cool that we're putting this on.
No, it's great. It's great.
Patreon.com, if you've never heard of it before, is a place to support independent content creators. like us, like me and Dick, and patreon.com/gizwiz is our page. And if you do want to give only one time, Patreon is a, you sign up and it's recurring. So every episode that we publish, you give a little bit. And you can set it whatever you want. It could be 50 cents, a dollar, something like that. And then every episode we publish, that happens. And you get like a transaction, I think, once a month. But if you don't want to do that, if you don't want to do recurring, we do have a PayPal link, gizwiz.tv, and you can go click the Patreon tab at the top, but then go ahead and click the PayPal link underneath the banner. Now, also, we are live about every Thursday. This Thursday, of course, was a little bit off, but we'll be back next Thursday, and you can watch us live at gizwiz.tv. Now, every time.
Every time you go to us live.
Every time. And that's also, I've realized why it happens, because I always mute it before the show. But because we embed the YouTube version, if I ever do any YouTube video and turn up the volume, it remembers that across websites. So I can't keep that muted. But there we are live at gizwiz.tv. You can join the chat room right below it. Or if you don't watch live, don't worry. You can subscribe to us. iTunes, RSS, HD, SD, audio versions, or YouTube. All available. Also, all of our show notes are available here at gizwiz.tv. We have two sites, basically. They're both sister sites. Gizwiz.tv and gizwiz.biz. Gizwiz.biz is run by Dick. And he writes up his own show notes, which are fantastic, and I suggest you check them out. So over at gizwiz.biz, there's even longer descriptions about all of the gadgets that we cover. While you're there, play What the Heck Is It? What the heck is this gadget? This is the whole gadget, not just part of the gadget, and we gotta guess what this is. And I say it's pretty obvious to me. It's a cheese grater for cheese wheel, because, you know, cheese wheels are circular and cheese graters are flat. So this one is a curved cheese grater for a curved cheese wheel. If you know what this gadget is, you can get a guessing over at gizwiz.biz. There's 12 Mad magazines signed by Dickie D himself for correct answers and 24 for hilarious, funny, bizarre, and clever answers. We support creativity and humor here on the GizWiz. So get a guessin' over at gizwiz.biz. That about wraps it up for this episode. We will see you next week.
I'll be here.